Greetings, everyone. Melcadrien here, and I'm here to show you Anomaly 2. On this channel, I've already shown off Anomaly, which is a tower offense game. And this game is pretty much the same formula, except revamped a little. I say revamped a little because some of the towers are different in this game. And not only that, but so are our weapons, you know. We get better weapons, and they get better weapons as well. So it's basically a improve scenario. We get better stuff, they get better stuff.
Finally, we reached the outskirts of New York City. Somewhere in the wreckage of its streets, Dr. Xander calls for help, but we're no longer able.
Unfortunately, the story about this is that, well, things have gone post-apocalyptic, and not with nuclear radiation, more like freezers. The entire world is going into a complete freeze, except for one area, the anomaly. Inside it is just completely warm. It's completely temperate. Everything outside the anomaly is basically a frozen wasteland.
Lieutenant, lay down sustained fire, and let's see what happens.
Hit that tin can with everything you got!
Holy shit! What a monster! Cut the chatter! Keep firing!
This is one of the new towers. Now this is our first unit. It is similar to the APC in the previous game, except for the fact that it has dual chain guns. And in order for its firepower to maximize, well, you're gonna have to, well, let it fire. That way when it fires, it will get faster. It's basically a revving. The more it revs, the more rounds it gets to fire out. If you don't, well, things are gonna turn out bad. Now, each weapon, each vehicle has their own modes. Like this one, the sledgehammer and the rocket hammer. The rocket hammer is basically a missile launcher bipedal tank. Well, bipedal vehicle, whereas the sledgehammer is a hovering tank. Both have their perks and their drawbacks. The rocket hammer doesn't have a whole lot of range, while the sledgehammer does. However, the sledgehammer can only go at a certain angle. It can only fire frontwards. It cannot go sidewards or backwards. It cannot fire at any direction, just front. The rocket hammer can, however.
We kick some butt.
I'll be damned.
This is a tech analysis for the enemy.
Don't need to know about these.
All clear. Now complete your squad and destroy this group.
Complete my squad, huh? Well, I don't want to go with the hounds because later in the further on there's gonna be those things that are just gonna rip my troop to shreds. So in a way I would want to have some tanks, some range weapons, some slow firing weapons. It's slow, yes, but it's very effective. That way you don't have to worry about losing them as easily. Okay, going to the world map. And move this way. Okay. like before, we can direct where our units go. Formation, morph into missiles.
I'll shove this rocket up your tin can ass. We're in.
Decoy. Repair. Making a return to this game is the power-ups. And in order to actually get the... be able to upgrade our vehicles, we need to collect these Karasarums. They can be laid all over the place. And it's a good idea to upgrade your vehicles with them. So that way they can last a little longer. So that way you don't have to worry about making sure they stay alive. And on the hardest modes, you gotta make sure. You gotta make sure they stay alive.
Slowly getting back. Lieutenant, keep
Decoy. Place another. Grab another decoy. It's nice that when you destroy some towers, they drop these power-ups for you. Go this route.
We're getting busted up here. We're taking serious damage. We're halfway to death, sir. We got it.
Got him. Grab these power-ups because every power-up is valuable. See what I mean by going with these slow rate of fire vehicles? If we brought in one of those hounds, we'd be in a world of hurt. Go outside, we'll go overhead. Get the Karasarum. Upgrade this unit? Better to be rich and healthy. One more, can you get it? Yes, you can. Perfect. Alright, we have a lot more jammers left. Let's see. We'll do the roundabout move. Just go around the entire block. Then hit the center. Repair. Decoy. Repair. Probably not a good idea to go down this alley. Oh well.
We're getting busted up here.
Fucking Well, there goes one of my vehicles.
Watch your backs out there.
Okay, I'm gonna have to pull out another sledge. Speed up. Just have them shoot me because, well, my armor can replenish. Okay, go this way and then go upwards. Actually, this one's almost dead.
Shot one down.
Get me a assault hound and morph it.
Information is go, sir. We're going up front.
There we go. Mission complete.
Dr. Xander is still broadcasting.
This is Dr. Klaus Xander from Manhattan Island, calling for help.
Good. Another distress signal coming in. We're honing in on it.
And after each complete mission, you get to see your score and your efficiency. I wasn't exactly efficient. I was kind of swift and ruthless. Not that bad. Not that good either. Still, that's pretty much what Anomaly is. You basically set up your team and make sure they don't die like what I did for my team. And if you really want to get the highest score, good luck. Because you're gonna need to be effective, ruthless, and swift at the same time. And that's something not a whole lot of people would be able to do on their first run. It would require some intense dedication. So, until next time, this is Melcadrien, and this has been the look at of Anomaly 2. I'll see you guys next time.